Okay, welcome dear students. Today I will teach you lesson number 11 on page number 47. That is Marathas, the protectors of the nation. That lesson was remaining with one batch. So today I will be teaching you that. So if you remember in the previous lesson, we have seen that how we have been expanding our Maratha power in the different parts of the country. Yes or no? So Marathas were always doing their efforts to expand our power in place of Mughal Empire. Yes or no? In the various parts of our country, India. So now let us see after that how they were protecting our nation. Okay? So in this chapter we will see who were the protectors of the nation. After Bajirao I, Sahu Maharaj appointed his son Balaji Bajirao alias Nana Sahib the Peshwa. Following the invasion of Nadir Shah, there was instability in Delhi. In these circumstances, Nana Sahib tried to stabilize the Maratha rule in the north. Okay, so we all know that after Bajirao was his son Balaji, what was his name? Balaji Bajirao alias Nana Sahib. You can remember the word Nana Sahib. Okay, he was appointed as the Peshwa. And then as Nadir Shah has invaded our country, you need remember the meaning of the word invaded? Yes, invaded means what? Lootna, loot ke chala na, okay? The one who is invading our wealth from the country. So that way Nadir Shah has invaded India, and there was a very, the situation was not stable that time in Delhi, right? Due to the invasion. So under these circumstances, Nana Sahib, as after he became the Peshwa, he tried to stabilize the conditions or the circumstances, whatever was there, he made all the efforts to make the conditions stable that time. Okay? So this way, he strived hard to make the conditions stable in the north. Then Amar Shah Abdali posed a challenge to the Marathas at Panipat. We shall learn about these developments in this chapter. Now, from the Mughals, who was there, who was imposing challenges to the Marathas? He was Amar Shah Abdali, right? Let us see now, what was the situation in the north? The region to the northwest of Ayodhya province at the foothills of the Himalayas was called Rohilkhand in the 18th century. The Pathans who had migrated from Afghanistan had settled in this region. They were known as Rohilas. The Rohilas had wrought havoc in the Dayab region of the Ganga and Yamuna rivers. The Nawab of Ayodhya invited the Marathas to subdue the Rohilas. The Marathas chastised the Rohilas. So what was the condition in the north? At that time, the one region to the northwest of Ayodhya, okay, that region was known as, it was lying at the foothills of the Himalayas. That region, that province which was lying at the foothills of the Himalayas towards the northwest of the Ayodhya, its name was Rohilkhand, okay? That region's name was Rohilkhand, and some people had migrated from, they were called as Pathans, and they had migrated from Afghanistan, okay? They had come from Afghanistan and shifted to this place, Rohilkhand. Okay, so who had come from Afghanistan? They were called as Pathans. But after they came to Rohilkhand and they started settling there in Rohilkhand, then they were called as Rohilas. What they were called as? Rohilas. So these Pathans from Afghanistan, they had settled there and they were called as Rohilas. And these people were not good. They were creating destruction in the places where they were staying. Okay, so that is the meaning of the wrought havoc. Means destroying the matters or the subjects around them. Okay, so this way they were creating the disturbance or destroying the things around them in that area. That's why the Nawab of Ayodhya was very much worried, because these people had come from Afghanistan and they are destroying the places and the, you know, territory and the forts and everything in their place. So that's why this Nawab, what he did, he asked help from who? Our powerful Marathas. The powerful Marathas, because that time were very powerful, so help was demanded from the Nawab of Ayodhya, and that's why these Marathas also became ready and they subdued these Rohilas. Which Rohilas? The Pathans of the Afghanistan. They made them feel low. Okay, subdued means what? To show them, to make them feel low. Okay, unko unki jagah batana. Okay, so that they were chastised. Means whatever deeds they were doing, they made them feel ashamed of the wrong things what they were doing. सो उनको नीचा दिखाना, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज सबड्यू. सो दिस वे मराठास चैटिसाइज द रोहिला. दैट वॉज द सिचुएशन इन द नॉर्थ दैट टाइम. Let us see now the conflict with the Afghans. So we always had conflict with the Afghans because the Abdali, Ahmad Shah Abdali, his aim was to, his eye was on India, yes or no? And that's why he was our enemy that time. Ahmad Shah Abdali, the ruler of Afghanistan, was attracted by the riches of India. I told you, uski aankh hamare हमारे इंडिया के कंट्री के वेल्थ पे थी. ओके, वॉट एवर आर द रिचनेस ऑफ आर कंट्री, हिज आई वॉज एन ही जस्ट वॉन्टेड, हिज अट्रैक्शन इन इंडिया वॉज द वेल्थ ऑफ द कंट्री इंडिया. ओके, ही मार्च्ड ऑन द पंजाब इन 1751 CE. देर वॉज एनार्की इन द मुगल टेरिटरी. वॉट डू यू मीन द एनार्जी? एनार्जी मीन्स कंप्लीट डिसऑर्डर. ओके, ड्यू टू द लैक ऑफ गवर्नमेंट, there is no government to rule in that place, then there is always disorder. When there is government to rule any country or any place, then always there is discipline, because we also fear, no, this is not legally allowed. We also follow those rules of the government, yes or no? So that time there was no government, and that's why there was anarchy, means there was disorder, there was nothing in order that time. Okay, so there was disorder in the Mughal territory. The Mughals were facing the threat of Abdali's invasion. On top of that, there was no government to rule their, to pay attention towards their security. And on top of that, they were having the threat. Unko dar tha ki Abdali any time will invade India. Yes or no? Because Abdali was interested in India's wealth. Yes or no? So that's why Mughals were very much worried that any time this Abdali will invade India. Okay? That time then what happened? In this circumstances, the Mughals found it necessary for their own protection to seek the help of the Marathas. Now the situation came that though Mughals and Marathas were enemy, but such situation came that the Mughals felt the need to take the help from the Marathas. Okay, and that's why they asked the help from the Marathas to protect them, because that time, you remember, we had expanded our Maratha power in the previous lesson we have studied. So whose power was powerful that time? Our Marathas power, right? So that's why help was asked from the Mughals to Marathas. Then what happened? The emperor was sure of the Marathas' strength and integrity. I told you why help was demanded from Marathas, because the Mughal emperor was knowing what is the strength of the Maratha and how much they are united. Integrity means unki unity aur unka strength, dono bhi cheeze Mughals were knowing of the Marathas, right? Then there was no other power strong enough to protect Delhi. So Mughals understood, now in this situation no other groups are so much powerful that they can protect our Delhi. Only Marathas are there, which are the powerful ones to protect Delhi. So therefore the emperor entered into a treaty with the Marathas in April 1752. According to this treaty, the Marathas agreed to protect the Mughal power from enemies like the Rohillas, the Jats, the Rajputs and the Afghans. In return, the Marathas were to get cash money, the right to collect chauthai in the territories of the Punjab, Multan, Rajputana, Sindh and Rohilkhand, and the Subedari of Ajmer and Agra provinces. So after this, when the Mughals decided to take help from Marathas, they signed a treaty. A treaty is means what? When two people or two groups, they make a understanding that we are going to help each other, then they have to sign a treaty. Okay, that is a one type of promise which they are making through the legal document, fine? So then they entered into treaty in 1752, and according to this treaty, what they agreed? They agreed what the Marathas asked from the, what did the Mughals ask from Marathas? That you have to protect us. Mughals were very much having threat, yes or no? That any there were so many enemies, they will invade us or they will attack us. So Mughals told that you have to protect our Delhi, and also you have to protect us and our kingdom from all our enemies. That is the work to be done by you. That was the treaty that Mughals had to, Marathas have to help the Mughals for protecting them and their kingdom, fine? Then in return, when Marathas are going to do the job, they should also get something in return, yes or no? They are going to put their lives in risk to protect them, yes? So in return, what Marathas demanded from Mughals, that you have to give us cash in money, okay? You have to give us money for our help to you. Also, you have to give what? The right to collect the chauthai in the territories of the... Which territories did he demand to collect the chauthai revenue? Do you remember? 1/4 part of the Mughal territory, chauthai. Yes? So, our Marathas demanded the right to collect chauthai of the territories Punjab, Multan, Rajputna, Sindh and Rohilkhand. And also they demanded the subedari of which place? Ajmer and Agra provinces, okay? So this was decided in the treaty and agreed upon by the Mughals and the Marathas, okay? I'll continue in the next video.